What's up, YouTube? It's your boy, it's your homie, Futuristic Mike, and I'm back with another PowerBook 2 Ghost video if you're new. Now, today we're going to be talking about the new PowerBook 2 Ghost characters. I'm going to be comparing them to the old Power characters. This is going to be fun because I've been wanting to talk about this for a while. If you're a fan of Power, if you love Power, hit the like on this video. If you're new to my channel and this is the first time you're finding me, subscribe and turn on those post notifications so when I post videos on PowerBook 2 Ghost, you get them. Now, a lot of people want to compare these new characters to the old characters, and I gotta say that there are some similarities. There really are. But we do kind of have to let these new characters stay in their own lane. You know what I mean? Like, we can compare them all we want, but then again, they are their own characters. Now, obviously, Tariq is gonna be like Ghost because he's Ghost's son. But as far as Brayden and everybody else that they're trying to compare, you know, Brayden is his own character. And as far as him being like Tommy, he has a long way to go. But I am gonna get into these similarities and I'm gonna compare all these characters. But before we dive into it, if you guys enjoy discussions like this, please be sure to give the video a like, subscribe, and turn on those post notifications so you can never miss any other uploads. Now, Ghost and Tariq are very smart and have business-like minds. They are able to get out of any situation. Ghost could handle things involving his street business and his club, but he always found a solution to his problems. Tariq always finds a solution to his problems as well. If he needs money, he finds a way to get it. He goes and hustles to the best of his ability. Tariq found a way to hire Davis McLean to help his mother get out of jail. He found a way to eliminate the competition at Stansfield, and now he's trying to figure out a way to outsmart the Tejadas. Both Tariq and Ghost are geniuses, and they are so much alike, like father, like son. Now, Brayden can be compared to Tommy. He's like Tommy in some ways, but not in every way. I feel like if Brayden was in the streets for many more years to come like Tommy was, then he could become what Tommy is, but he has a long way to go. Tommy grew up in the streets with Ghost and didn't have money like that. He made a way with Ghost and stacked up so much money as possible, to open up Club Truth and all these other businesses, the laundromats and stuff. But Brayden was born with wealth. His family is rich and had a lot to do with building Stansfield. Tommy's family never had money. I mean, look at Kate Egan. That explains it all. Tommy and Brayden are alike in some ways. They want to hustle no matter what. Tommy always wanted to be a part of the street business at all times, even when he didn't have to. He had so many opportunities to get out of the life with Ghost, but he didn't want to. Brayden is the same way. His family is rich and he doesn't need to hustle, but he chooses to. Brayden flips out on people just like Tommy used to. We seen Brayden get pissed because people were taking pictures at the James St. Patrick vigil hosted by Professor Milgram. We also seen Brayden beat the brakes off of the competition at a party in the last episode. That fight right there really reminded me of Tommy because he lost his cool and he wanted to keep beating on him. And that's something Tommy would do. You know, that's something he would do, no doubt, because Tommy had a hot temper and he always wanted to beat somebody up. You know, remember when Tommy tried to beat up Julio because Julio came over to his apartment and he thought Julio was trying to flirt with Holly and everything? He beat the brakes off Julio. So I can see some similarities between Brayden and Tommy in that way. Brayden always wants to fight and everything. I mean, we're talking about the guy that bubble wrapped some guys and threw them off a roof just to prove a point. Remember that episode when Tommy did that? Tommy is one crazy mother. I'm telling y'all, he's crazy. And if Brayden spends enough time in his life, then he could definitely become like Tommy. Now, Lauren is like Angela Valdez in so many ways. Angela grew up in the hood with James, and she didn't really have money like that, so she had to make a way for herself. And she became an assisted United States attorney. I feel like Lauren is gonna do the same thing. She will make a way for herself and become very successful unless somehow she gets wrapped up in Tariq's drug life and gets hurt or killed. And if PowerBook 2 is anything like Power going forward, then Lauren will probably get hurt. The difference between Lauren and Angela is Angela didn't have money growing up, and it seems like Lauren does. Lauren has some bougie ass parents and a nice house. She's even dating a guy named Malcolm, who her parents probably picked for her because they want her to date a bougie ass dude. At the end of the day, she will end up with Tariq. Lauren and Angela both have the same type of minds and are so much alike. Now let's talk about Diana and Tasha. Tasha went to school before she met Ghost. Her and Ghost met each other, I think, when she was like 18 years old. She didn't have to make a way for herself because Ghost gave her the life she only could have dreamed of. She wanted Ghost to be the biggest damn drug dealer in New York City. And Ghost has said this so many times. I know you guys remember, he always said to Tasha, "You want me to be the biggest damn drug dealer in New York City." I think if Tariq were to get together with Diana, she might want what's best for Tariq at first, but eventually that's all she'll want for him. You know, the same thing Tasha wanted for Ghost, for him to be the biggest in the game, Diana will want that for Tariq too. Diana sees what her family does, and she sees how her mom and dad operate, so that's all she knows. She will follow the leader, who is Monet. She's teaching her everything she knows. Diana actually wants to go to school and play ball, but Monet won't let her. Diana and Tasha are alike because Tasha was involved in the streets, laundering money, throwing ideas to Ghost, and so on. Diana is handling things for Monet in the same way. She would probably act like Tasha acted with Ghost towards Tariq. I just feel like Lauren is the better choice when it comes to Tariq dating somebody. The difference between Ghost and Tariq is Tariq can actually make the decision to choose the right woman, you know, which is obviously Lauren. If Tariq falls for Lauren and then ends up with Diana instead and marries her and has kids, that's the same cycle as Ghost. And then Lauren will probably end up popping back up in the future if he ever opens up a nightclub or something like Ghost did, and they'll run into each other one night. Just like what happened with Ghost and Angie when Angie was rocking that red dress in the very first episode of Power. That might happen with Tariq later on in life if he decides to be with Diana. You know, he might run into Lauren later on and they might catch up. You know, he might open up a business and she might come in there and everything. It might be like the same thing. And maybe the writers are going for something like this. I think that would be pretty dope for like Power Book 2 to end and you see Tariq, you know, owning a nightclub or something. That would be pretty dope. Now let's get to Kane and Kanan. Obviously, Kane is the most like Kanan. Some people said Kane reminds them of Tommy, but personally, I think he acts just like Kanan. Yes, Kane is ruthless and hot-headed just like Tommy was, but he is so much more like Kanan because he just doesn't care about nothing. Kane was willing to go as far as killing a cop in the third episode until he didn't have to. Kanan killed so many cops when he died because he didn't want to go back to jail. We never saw Tommy do any shit like that. Kanan killed his own son Sean for not being loyal and listening. I feel like Kane would kill a family member for the same reason, possibly Drew and maybe Monet. I think Kane would actually go as far as killing a family member, and that's the same thing Kanan did. Now, Kane was made for the streets just like Kanan was. We are gonna see in Power Book 3 Raising Kanan why Kanan was the way he was, and I'm sure if we get more of a backstory on Kane, we would see why he is the way he is. But Kane has a reputation to uphold, and so did Kanan. Kanan got out of jail and had to prove that he still had the juice that he had before he got locked up. After all, Kanan was the one who ran things back in the day. He was telling Ghost and Tommy what to do, so he ran the organization. I just think Kane and Kanan are so much more alike than Kane and Tommy. If Kanan was still alive, him and Kane would make a crazy duo together for real. Now let's talk about Davis McLean and Joe Proctor. Both of these two characters were badass in their own way, and they are so similar. Both of them are super skilled lawyers and know what they're doing in the courtroom, and both of them have juice. They have the juice. When we first were introduced to Proctor, Julio came to collect money from him, and then Ghost hired him to represent Tommy in court after Tommy and Lobos got caught at the Carlton Hotel. Proctor had to represent Tommy. Proctor came onto the show and knew what he was doing right away. The first time I saw him, I'm like, oh yeah, I love this character. Now Davis was introduced when Tariq went to court to watch him work. We've seen how good Davis was with his words, and he could get clients off like it was nothing. Then Tariq tricked him into taking the case by going on Instagram Live. It worked, and he took the case to potentially become the biggest criminal defense attorney in New York City. I would have loved if Proctor was still alive to maybe see these two work together. Proctor and Davis McLean in the courtroom together would be crazy. Now that would be an unstoppable team. These two lawyers are comparable because they are so well skilled when it comes to convincing a judge that the client didn't do the crime. It's a little harder for McLean than it ever was for Proctor because Tasha is facing such a hard case. You know, she's facing so much time. But Proctor has always done a fantastic job. Some people say Proctor wasn't loyal, but I still think he was. You know, he was loyal every season of Power. After all, he was just doing what was best for his daughter, Elisa Marie Proctor, so he had to do what he had to do. I loved Proctor's character. I really loved Davis McLean too. The acting from Proctor was always on point, and the acting so far from McLean is fantastic. Now, these are all the new characters that can be compared to the old characters. There are so many things alike between the comparable characters and some different characteristics as well. But if we were comparing them, that's what it would be. Tariq would be Ghost, Brayden Tommy, Lauren Angela, Tasha Diana, Kane Kanan, and Proctor Davis. I'm not even gonna compare Drew's fruity ass to anyone because no one was like him in the original Power, so we can just skip over him. But please, Courtney Kemp and 50 Cent and everybody else involved in the show, don't ever, 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 ever show any gay shit like that again. That was just too much and I did not need to see that. And I know everybody else is thinking the same thing. I've read some really negative comments about that gay scene and it was just not needed. Seriously, it was not needed. It's different if Drew turns out to be gay and it just shows him kissing somebody or something, but we did not need to see that whole scene. That was just unnecessary and that was too much for my eyes. I didn't need to see that, man. So I'm not even gonna compare Drew to anybody. I compared every other new character to somebody in the old Power, but I'm not gonna compare Drew to nobody because there was no gay characters in the first Power except for Lobos and then Simon Stern. But they didn't even show nothing in Power Book 1. You know, we knew Simon Stern was bisexual because he had that little orgy party or whatever. And then we seen Lobos getting head in the pool in Season 2. But that was about it. So I'm not going to compare Drew to nobody. But what do you guys think about what I said? Do you agree with my comparisons? Do you think the new characters will become more and more like the old characters of Power? I think they definitely will grow more and more into being like the old characters. I just can't wait to see what happens with all these new characters. And I can't wait to see what happens with the old characters that we still have that are on Power Book 2 Ghost. And I can't wait to see Tommy appear. I really can't wait for that one. Because I want to see Tommy and Brayden next to each other. That would be something to see. Seriously, that would be something. But comment what you guys think down below in the comment section. What do you think about the comparisons? Do you think what I said is on point? If you have anything else to add about the comparisons of these characters, comment down below and let me know. Comment your theories, thoughts, predictions, and everything down below for the rest of the season of Power Book 2 Ghost. Keep supporting your boy, and I'll be continuing to bring y'all Power Book 2 Ghost content in the future. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and smash that notification bell so you can never miss a video. Let me get out of here, y'all. It's your boy Futuristic Mike, and I'll talk to y'all on the next one. I'm out. Peace.